let's discuss radius of gyration. We can simply write about radius of gyration as it is the equivalent radius of circular motion for a rigid body in rotation. Like if we are having a rigid body which is rotating about a given axis of rotation, so it is of mass m, body is rotating about this axis of rotation, then if there is a point where we concentrate the whole mass of body in such a way that if this is the axis of rotation and we consider the whole mass of body concentrated at a point which is located at distance k from the axis of rotation, and if the mass revolves in a circular motion of radius k such that the moment of inertia of this point mass is equal to the moment of inertia of this body, then k is defined as radius of gyration of this rigid body. So if moment of inertia of the rigid body about the given axis is I, if this I can be written as mk square, because for the point mass in a circular motion moment of inertia can be written as mk square, then this k can be written as radius of gyration of body, which can be written as root of I by m. This is the expression we use for calculation of radius of gyration of a body about any given axis of rotation. Obviously, if we change the axis of rotation for a given body, its radius of gyration changes. Like if we talk about a ring, we can write for a ring about the central axis of rotation. We can say about central axis of rotation, radius of gyration can be written as root of I by m, that can be written as r only, because moment of inertia we write as mk square. So if radius of gyration for a ring about central axis of rotation is r, then moment of inertia will be mk square. Similarly, for the ring, if we talk about its diametrical axis of rotation, so we can write for diametrical axis of rotation k, we can write as r by root 2. Because in this situation, if k is equals to r by root 2, the moment of inertia we get will be mr square by 2. Similarly, for a sphere, if we talk about central axis of rotation, we know that moment of inertia is equals to 2 by 5 mr square. So in this situation, we can equate it to mk square. This will give us radius of gyration as root of 2 by 5 r. In this manner, we can find out moment of inertia of any given object if its radius of gyration is known. Or similarly, if moment of inertia is known, we can find out its radius of gyration. Like again, if we talk about for a solid cone about central axis of rotation, we can state about central axis of rotation, the moment of inertia of cone is written as 3 by 10 mr square, which we can equate to mk square. So a radius of gyration of a cone about central axis of rotation we can write as root 3 by 10 r. This is the way how we analyze radius of gyration and the relation of moment of inertia with radius of gyration.